Your first two Bruce Bell Performance Ironman Modified Division Series qualifiers, first out the 77. Out of Kewanee, Illinois, that is Ray Bollinger. And Bob Pierce with the Butch Smith Engine American Protection, Lewis Truck and Auto, Wagers Lawn Service on that machine. 16.323 on that lap. The other car out, Marksville's North Carolina's Richard Clue at a Twister chassis with GM 602, sponsored by Harmony Transmission. He went a 16.161 on the second lap for Ray Bollinger. And 16.480 on the second lap for Marksville, North Carolina's Richard Clue. Your next two modified qualifiers out in the 11 out of London, Kentucky. That is Jamie Mosley on a Larry Shaw race car with a Corey Racing engine, sponsored by Crossbar Premium Electronic Cigarettes and Boss Cheer Gymnastics. He's joined by the driver of the 29 out of Andrews, North Carolina. This is Steve Clark. He had one of the former Cottman Racing machines. It's a laser chassis with the Andrews Engine Service power plant beneath the hood, sponsored by Clark's Auto. 17149 for the former ARCA and Nationwide Series competitor Jamie Mosley. Lap number one for Clark. Did not pick up. 16873 on the second lap. There he is. We'll roll out with our next pair of qualifiers. See the number 20 machine. He's out of Mohawk, Tennessee. That is Brad Dyer on Lightning with a Big Hill race engine, sponsored by S&S Mill Ride and Corner Market. He's joined by the 20 out of Pedro, Ohio, Brian Skaggs, and a Rocket by Ruhlman, sponsored by Gary's Auto Body, Matney Truck and Trailer Repair, Pickett Concrete, and DC Tree Service. 16.832, first lap time showing right there for Brad Dyer. First lap for Ohio native Brian Skaggs, 16.588. Lap number two coming up for Brad Dyer. He'll go a 16.533. And Pedro, Ohio's Brian Skaggs coming down to complete his second lap, 17.011. Kentucky, that is Tim Patrick. Tim Patrick in a pro-built chassis with a D&D race engine, sponsored by Markham Trucking, Murphy Roofing, D&D Trucking, and Anthony's Auto Sales. He'll be joined by the number two out of Powell, Tennessee. That is Jimmy Dalton. Jimmy Dalton in a Hoffman race car with a Smiley race engine, sponsored by Affordable Car Care, Lee's Performance Repairs, Joe's Barbershop, Hamels Tires, Supermoon Graphics, West Haven Speed Equipment, and Pro Blast Surface Preparation. 16.987 on lap one for Tim Patrick. Lap one coming up for Jimmy Dalton right here in the deuce. Here goes 16.216. Put Dalton in second quick behind Ray Bollinger, who is fast time right now. Ray Bollinger, excuse me. 16.848 on a second lap for Patrick. Lap number two coming up for Dalton. 16.360. Bollinger is a quick. Dalton, regular two of them here today. Brian Skaggs, one of them. This is the other one in the double zero out of Wheelersburg, Ohio. Justin Cooper in a Larry Shaw race car with an RHR race engine, sponsored by Moe's Southwest Grill, Wicked Weasel Fabrication, Vinyl Craft Window and Doors, and Conley Trucking. He's joined by the veteran in the T92 machine out of Knoxville, Tennessee, Billy Palmer. He had a Warrior with an Eagle on the Hardin Valley Paint and Body, Mighty Muffler and Brake sponsored machine at 16.588 on lap number one for Justin Cooper. Lap one coming up for Billy Palmer in the former Ricky Tench T92. Here goes 17.898. Justin Cooper on his second lap, 16.266. Put Cooper into third quick now. And the second and final lap for Billy Bobber, 17.559. Way back in November in the 98 out of Sargoinsville, Tennessee. That is Sean Flannery, Flannery and an MB custom chassis with a Mullins race engine, sponsored by Napa, West Liberty, Fast Trucking, Custom Suspension, Casva, Angus Farm, Will Kinzer Foundation for Autism Research, Penske Shocks, Hypercoil and Auto Body Specialist. And he's joined by the 50 of the driver out of Wartburg, Tennessee. That's Amos Bunch. Bunch and a Bandit with a Smiley Race Engine, Red's Muffler Shop, Windrock Photography, Race Carburation, Smiley's Race Engines all on board of that one. 16401 on lap 14. Flannery, 16401 on lap 1. The lap 1 for Amos Bunch, 16649, 16649. And lap number 2 for Sean Flannery coming up right here. He is off turn number 4. 16066, and that is quick time of the afternoon now for the Bruce Bilt Performance Ironman Modified. Sean Flannery and 16921, 16921. On the second lap for Amos Bunch, but Sean Flannery right there in the number 98. He'll go to the top of the leaderboard as quick time. We will have Crate Lake Model Bs. Now our final two qualifiers, see the 47, the second generation racer out of Knoxville, Tennessee, Brad Hall. Brad Hall in a Bruce Bilt race car, sponsored by Bruce Bilt Performance and Townsville Chiropractic. And he'll be joined now. They got the transponder replaced. On the 29 of Andrew, North Carolina native Steve Clark. Brad Hall, he'll come down and complete his first lap, 16.078. Second quick, 16.078 for Brad Hall. First lap time for Steve Clark in the 29. He'll go 17.257, 17.257, 12th quick. Yet Hall working off turn number 4 to complete his the second and final lap, 16.153, 16.153. His first lap good enough for second quick. And second lap, 16.820, 16.820 looks like there.
Here, guys.
And the field will now get the one to go signal.
You'll have to let him in. He's not leaking anything now. We can check him out here, so let him in there. Come on up here.
And caution lights are going out, and we're getting ready to come to green on the first ever Bruce Bilt Performance Ironman Modified Division Series A main event. Flannery and Hall set to bring them to green. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime, and here we go. They'll drive off into turn number 1. Who's going to come out of there with the race lead? Brad Hall going to nose out in front of Sean Flannery. Down the back straightaway is Ray Bollinger. And Jimmy Dalton goes side by side for the third spot as they work off turn number 4 to complete lap number 1. Brad Hall will have the race lead. Hall, your leader. Flannery in second. Bollinger is third. Dalton fourth. Dalton getting some pressure now from the double zero machine. That is Justin Cooper out of Wheelersburg, Ohio. That is for the fourth spot, but Dalton going to hang on to the position for the time being. Meanwhile, Hall looking nice and smooth out in front right now, keeping about a 3-4 car length advantage over Sean Flannery here in the early going of this one. We'll have three laps of 25 in the books this time by 3 down, 22 to go. Super late model A main. Do you need to be getting them in staging? The Schaefer's Oil Ironman Mountain or Ironman Championship Series Super late model Cabin Fever 40 A main. You need to be getting staged, please. Four laps in the books now. Hall continues to lead the way. Flannery is second. Bollinger is third. Dalton fourth. Cooper fifth. Richard Clue is sixth. Brian Skaggs seventh. Brad Dyer eighth. Tim Patrick ninth. Amos Bunch is tenth. Then it's Jamie Mosley. Steve Clark. And Billy Palmer. He has the front three of Hall, Flannery, and Bollinger start to put some distance now between himself and the battle for fourth between the two of Jimmy Dalton and the double zero of Justin Cooper. We'll have a lucky seven laps in the books this time by. We'll have seven down and 18 to go for race leader Brad Hall, who's got that Bruce Bilt Performance Townsville Chiropractic sponsored machine out in front as Richard Clue's F5. Slows coming down the main straightaway, and he's going to pull his machine to the center of the infield, and his day looks to be finished. 8 into books, field work in lap number 9. Flannery now trying to gain some ground on Hall as those two have put just a little bit of distance now between himself and the 77 of Illinois native Ray Bollinger. Dalton still in a fourth with the double O of Justin Cooper holding down the final spot in the top five. We'll have 10 scored right here, 10 down, 15 to go. Hall continues to lead the way with Flannery in position number 2. Super late models coming up next. And the 29 of Steve Clark's machine rolls to the infield off the center of the back straight away. His day looks to be finished as we start to close in on the midpoint of this event. Brad Hall continues to lead the way, working the bottom around Boyd Speedway, keeping that Bruceville chassis car nice and straight. The MB Customs of Sean Flannery, about 2.5, 3 car lengths off his back bumper, still rides in second. Ray Bollinger holds down the third spot. Jimmy Dalton fourth. And fifth still goes to Justin Cooper as they've got about 3/4 of a straightaway back to the sixth place running machine now, that being the 20 of Brian Skaggs. As we get ready to see the halfway signal, got a car slowing up at the top of turn 1 and 2, and caution is out. Caution a wave as Amos Bunch rolls slowly to a stop up in turn number 2. So we'll show the field the 1 to go signal and come back to green next time by. 13 official, 12 remain. Again, Schaefer's Oil, Ironman Championship Series, Super Late Models. You need to be getting them in staging for your Cabin Fever 40 main event. As we're halfway home in the Cabin Fever 25 right here, and Brad Hall will set to pace and bringing them around back to green here off turn number 4. And here we go. Bollinger, he'll look to the outside of Flannery for the second spot as they race off turn 2 down the back straightaway now. Bollinger trying to make the middle and high side work, and he may be clear of Flannery as they race off into turn 3. Off of turn number 4, they're still side by side for the lead for that second spot. Hall continues to show the way as Ray Bollinger and Sean Flannery battle for second. Give the Duke for the runner-up spot to Ray Bollinger. And let's see Bollinger now. He's going to try to set his sights on race leader Brad Hall as we've got less than 10 to go, 9 of them remaining. Brad Hall, one of the top runners in modified competition during the 2016 season in East Tennessee at his home track of Tazewell Speedway. Ray Bollinger, one of the top seasoned UMP Dirt Car modified competitors in the country, riding in the runner-up spot. And Sean Flannery, another seasoned veteran with victories all over this part of the United States, riding in third. A lot of feature wins up front in this one. And Flannery, he'll work back beneath Bollinger for the bridesmaid spot down into turn number 1. They're side by side again for second and put Flannery back to second here on lap number 19. As Brad Hall continues to hold the race lead with 6 laps remaining, a trophy dash will finish it. Hall, your leader. Flannery now back to second with Bollinger in third. Jimmy Dalton fourth and Justin Cooper, the final car in the top 5. As the 5 to go indicator has been shown to them. 20 in the books, 5 remain. Super late model A main coming up following this one. Cooper trying to get a run on Dalton for the 4th spot off 2. Not able to make the move as Flannery's gotten away from Bollinger here a bit and trying to run down the race leader Brad Hall in the waning laps of this one. Hall's led it the entire way. We'll put 22 laps up on the board this time as Flannery closing in on turns 3 and 4, trying to chase down Brad Hall with 3 to go. Hall trying to work to keep that car nice and straight while Flannery kind of letting it hang out a bit in an effort to try to chase Hall down. He lost some ground off turn 2 that time. As the 2 lap to go indicator going to be shown by Wesley Womack to the field, 2 to go. And battle for that 4th spot between the 2 of Dalton and the double O of Cooper, but Dalton hanging on to it tough for the time being. Meanwhile, off of turn number four, the white flag's going to be displayed to your race leader, Brad Hall. One lap to settle it. Hall taking him down the back straightaway one more time. He'll set that car down into turn number three. Yet off of turn number four, Knoxville, Tennessee's Brad Hall, the winner of the Bruce Bell Performance Ironman Modified Division Series A main event. Sean Flannery will come home second. Ray Bollinger will finish third. Jimmy Dalton comes home fourth. And the 00 of Justin Cooper completes the top five. And getting the safety equipment off. And he's out of the car. Give him a big round of applause, race fans. The winner of the Bruce Bell Performance Ironman Modified Division Series, Cabin Fever 25 out of Knoxville, Tennessee, Brad Hall. Young man, congratulations. Before we go to snapping the camera here and get some pictures made, well, now you're going to be the answer to a trivia question. Who won the first Bruce Bell Performance Ironman Modified Division Series A main event? Your name goes in the record books, Brad Hall. Congratulations.
I appreciate it very much. Been a pretty neat deal to get the modifies down here at Boyd's. I'd like to thank Mr. DePlissy, Dale McDowell, all the folks involved for getting this, doing this race for the series. I love the modifieds. They're a lot of fun. I've raced here a lot at Boyd's. I've run second, I've run third, but I've never won a race down here. And it's a great opportunity to be here, get this win. Thanks to Bruce Bell Performance, Tazzle Chiropractic, all the folks that help us. This is a family operation, and we're sure glad to be here. Hoosier Racing Tire, those folks helped out a lot too.
And you know, you mentioned right there, you raced a little bit of everything throughout the course of your racing career, super late models, limited late models. What was the reason? What'd you make the move and start going modified racing here 1 year ago?
Man, these modifieds are old school. The front clip on this car actually rolled off an assembly line somewhere in a Chevrolet plant from a 68 to 70 Chevelle. The back half of this car is a tube late model type chassis. We got to run little bitty tires. It's old school. It's old school and it's fun. You're slipping, you're sliding, you're having a race, and that's why I like it.
Race fans, give him a big round of applause. Out of Knoxville, Tennessee, Brad Hall, winner of tonight's Bruce Bell Performance Ironman Modified Division Series A main event.